away from you.
The place is not the home, but the people are the home. And camp is the same way. None of us are the same. Not one of us are the same out there, but we all come together for one common thing. When you have that group of people around and the camaraderie that happens, the learning that happens, the conversations that happen, that's camp.
For those of us who are passionate about the outdoors and about the wild turkey, we know this lifestyle transcends the seasons. The few short weeks of spring are only the tip of the iceberg. That's why we celebrate this way of life all year long. This is NWTF 365.
You know, 3 years ago, I was looking into a snow goose hunt, and this outfitter was suggested to me to try, and I got about 14 people to go, and it was a mixture of guys and girls, couples, singles, and we came out here, and we get to shoot or we don't get to shoot, and we still have a great time. Last year, I ended up taking 34 in two different weekends, and one weekend was just all girls. We didn't see one bird that weekend with all girls, and we still had a blast. I kept hearing snow goose is a trash bird. It's a trash meat. Just donate it. Don't try it. And so the first time I went snow goose hunting, I brought home 50 birds and breasted them out that night until 2 a.m. and made the most delicious meals out of them. And I think it's just in how you prepare them, how you respect the bird, how you respect the meat and process it and prepare it into something really nice and beautiful. Year we've got actual birds flying over, and we've got 10 on the ground, which last year we didn't see any birds. So in the past we've only done one day, and so we've had to hunt and then everybody leaves. And I think this year, stepping into, we are hunting 2 days, it allows that night in between that we're going to be able to hang out and talk about the day. It's not necessarily the Ritz, but at the same time, it's a fun experience because you're not necessarily focused on your surroundings. You're focused on why you're there. So it's not about the place that you stay at, even though you get to giggle just a little bit about it. It's a conservation hunt here, whether you're in Arkansas, Missouri, or you move on up as the birds go, but it's a conservation hunt. It's no limit. You're trying to help out farmers, keeping the Canadian tundra safe because there are so many snow geese destroying it right now. Being able to come and hunt snow geese is a way that you can unload, literally unload your gun and do something impactful. I think that you should definitely take a moment and when you're picking your hunts and ask yourself, why am I going on these hunts? Why am I inviting people to go on these hunts? Is it just for fun, which is okay, but is there an impact behind it? Because I think that that is a way that you can communicate to non-hunters a little bit more of why we do this. It adds a different perspective to it. Conservation has this big picture to it. People use that word in general for a whole lot of things, whether it's non-hunters, anti-hunters, or hunters. I think that hunters can specify the word conservation in a different way. We can apply it to really raising our species, whether it's turkey, duck, whatever it is, we can make an impact on that. You see that in the numbers. You see that in turkey numbers and how they were so depleted. I mean, in Tennessee, they were almost non-existent. And it was just a steady work of limits and being very careful and conserving that species. I do look forward to this because a lot of these people that I hunt with have been here for 3 years, the 3 years that we've been doing it, and their family. It's not something that I want to miss even if tragedy hits. My dad passed away Monday, and there are people that are out there right now that I needed hugs from and I needed to be around, and I think that people that you hunt with become your family, not just friends, not just acquaintances, but they really do become family. And I think that that's why I look forward to it every year.